In a world where nuclear war has begun, vampires fought back in super real 3D.
I've just hit record on my phone to test out active track on the Ronin DJI RSC2, Ronin SC2. I have to run this test because I'm hoping to use this at an upcoming shoot for Trans Am Worldwide, who has just released, finally unveiled what the car is, which is the 70SS. And it is a tribute to the Chevelle, 1970 Chevelle. So it's a real big deal in the muscle car market. And I am testing out this active track because I'm going to actually take this unit holding the Canon EOS R, the original EOS R. And I'm actually going to put it on this monopod right here. And I can then stick this out of the van rather than always hanging outside of the van. Maybe I can get a little more reach. Maybe I can get some height. Maybe I can get some cool low shots. And then hopefully the active track will assist me with the super smooth option that it also has in its algorithm. And hopefully we'll get some new different types of shots that I've never gotten before, which will be really cool. And I use a combination of the EOS R. And I have used a Sony A7S with a 7Q in the past to get some of these car-to-car driving shots, and I put that on a Ronin M, which is still up here, the original Ronin M. I still got it. I still use it. But now this might fully replace it. I also have the Zenyu Crane. You won't be able to see this through the light, but I have a Crane 3S, and that actually is what can hold my Red Epic Dragon, which is a much heavier camera system, and this could not hold that. That cannot hold that. And it is a lot to wield, but it does create some great steady shots. That is by Jiyun, and this is by DJI. Now, I've gotten products from both, and before I ordered this unit right here, I actually had ordered the Weeble S, which is a two-year-old unit, 1 year older than, I believe, the RSC2 when it came out. And I went that route because, well, it was just, it seemed like a little bit more bang for the buck. I came across a used pro kit. And then I ordered that from B&H, got it, and then there were no pro kit options, which would have included the image transmitter, which allows for its version of active track. It also had its motor mount system that wasn't there. I'm sorry, rack focus with a little motor that was missing. And then I contacted B&H used department. It was a lot of hassle, actually. I won't go through the full, I normally like B&H, but this was a bad experience. And at the end of the day, they said that that was just the wrong unit. It was just a Weeble S. And I was like, well, then I could have bought a brand new one for $60 cheaper than this, because you guys have a deal going right now on the new ones, and said, yeah, it's ridiculous. Please send it back. You'll have to order a different one, blah, blah. Long story short, I ordered the next one, got it. This isn't a long story short. I ordered another Weeble S. All right. And then I got it and I was like, all right, now I got the full kit. I just went ahead and bought the new one. It was reasonably priced. It was $560. I got the full pro kit. Okay. I was like, all right. And then I go to put the EOS R on it, and it's too big for that unit, which I thought, you know, it's a relatively small mirrorless camera. However, I think in particular, because I'm using an adapter that allows for EF lenses to be used on the EOS R, which is a native RF mount, I have all EF glass. So I'm using an adapter on there that made it that much longer, which put it all the way to the back, and it could not fit. It couldn't do the full pitch. So then I ended up sending that one back. And then I decided to get the Ronin DJR. DJR. Can we just call it a DJR? DJI RSC2. And that's what we're testing right now with the active track. So now I don't know how good it's working. We're going to find out. I've done very minimal testing. I have to do a lot more testing before I do car-to-car driving shots. I'm in a bit of a hampered state for testing because I am so damn busy. I mean, it has been ridiculous. And one of the aspects that's made my life completely full is that I just had a newborn child 2 weeks ago. So even making this right now is a struggle. And this brings me to the point of why this video is not really like my other ones, where it's cutting away to, you know, examples of shots that I want to reference, and it's cutting away to the product, or it's cutting. I just don't have time. And I haven't had time to do that for quite a while between trying to keep up paid work, the passion project that I've been working on for 2 years now, the sci-fi comedy rock album web series, which is, I want to talk about that more in a different little update. We'll do that later. And then now I have baby. I already have another son that's 15 and he's coming of age, and I got to be a father to him as well. I got to keep up the family stuff, got to keep up the property. It is just too many things. Now, I missed making little videos like this, and I want to talk about gear because obviously I like rambling on about camera stuff. And I am over here in Tallahassee, Florida, pretty much working by myself. I mean, I bring on additional shooters to help here and there, but most of the work that I'm doing is editing. I'm by myself. A lot of the film shoots I'm doing by myself. Most of the things that you see on roughcutproductions.com, I did by myself. So I don't have somebody to talk to about all this stuff. And I, you know, to be honest, I don't have much of a social life at this point because I stay so busy. I'm always wanting to create something. I'm just absolutely addicted to it. So most of my socialization is getting to hang out with people where I'm actually getting to, you know, collaborate and make stuff, which is part of the thing that kind of pulled into the whole Cue the Muses web series thing. Now, it's quite a tangent, just to explain that what I could do is make little videos like this, which are just little updates and little tech talk, and not TikTok, but tech talk, and you could follow along if you want to. Now, I feel like it's valuable information, and sometimes I might just be talking about what it's like running the business or marketing decisions, stuff like that. If you're, you know, thinking about starting your own video business, it is very involved. I mean, my schedule is usually 4:30 a.m. you know, till 5:30 to 6:30 p.m. That's pretty much my schedule for the workday. However, woven into that is a little bit of meditation, a little bit of exercise, a little bit of guitar practice. So I try to get those things in to keep sane, and those are blended in at the right time. That's part of why I get up at 4:30 in the morning, which, by the way, I wake up naturally at 4:30 in the morning now because I've gotten my circadian rhythm so dialed in. You can do that. I wake up no alarm. I'll just wake up at 4:30 in the morning, and on the weekends, I usually wake up around the same time, unless I've stayed up for a UFC fight night, which is my one of the very few social things that I still do. I'll do a little fight night. We'll have some people over. We'll watch a pay-per-view. I love martial arts. That's my other thing. That's part of my workout. All right. I always hit the bag and do some different stuff. Anyway, that's another tangent. But I want to make little updates, and I want to be a little active. So follow along if you'd like. And I look forward to just kind of making these like little journal entries and just, you know, this is a real taste of what I'm thinking about at the time with different gear coming out. I want to talk more about the Canon EOS R5C. There's, you know, now that there's way more videos out and it's been coming out, it's a very, very cool camera. It is the one that I have my eye on. If I get the right travel gig, I will probably try to get that guy. And anyway, I want to talk about it in comparison to the Komodo because I feel like that's the other price range thing that you'd be looking at, and the C70. I mean, those are kind of the three: Canon C70, you know, the Red Komodo, and the EOS R5C. As far as picture quality, I'll just say out of the gate, I still think the Komodo actually wins, and I've seen some comparisons by Camkey that really solidified that for me. I was like, yeah, Red still has it, but the EOS R5C is just so much more versatile and so much more sense for, makes so much more sense for me, because I just need a better travel camera rig. Right now we're filming on the EOS R and it's a great little camera, but that crop at 4K really does kind of suck, and I miss 10-bit color. I really like to get some 10-bit color, and I'd like to have 60 frames per second at 4K. So it's not even about the 8K and all that, it's just those things. So obviously I cannot resist rambling about this shit once I start talking, and I'd like to be able to do it more than I get to. So I'm gonna try this out. Now, for today, how did this active track work? And how did the focus work? Because I did some other tests and it was really hunting. And I think that's not a fault of, you know, the Ronin. That's just me getting to experience a live view mode here and just not operating the camera. A lot of times if I'm operating the camera, you know, if it's not on a gimbal, I'm usually using a, you know, manual focus. And all my other cameras are manual focus. So really the EOS R is the only one with the autofocus, which makes it ideal for the gimbal work. Anyway, we'll see what came in and out. Be forgiving. And yeah, I'm sorry that it's not cutting away. I could either make nothing or I could start making little updates like this. So hopefully you're interested. And if not, well, no worries. I kind of think it's pretty cool to have some journal entries like this, just talking about gear over the course of time. Just having a little more consistent content. I also want to talk about making shorts and the reels and stuff. You know, there's like shorts on YouTube, there's reels on Instagram, there's now reels on Facebook and social media marketing and what I think about those and what I've experienced trying to test them and what I'm thinking about doing with them for clients and the vertical aspect ratio. And I love landscape. So it's, you know, there's a lot going on with that. I've been testing out shorts and stuff. And I don't know, there's opinions that I'm forming about. I know they can be quite successful for a lot of people, but for me, I'm still like, I don't know. I think me, I don't know. I like making more full long stuff. I'm a little bit long-winded in case you can't tell. I will catch you guys hopefully around on these next little updates, and oftentimes they'll be shorter than this. That way I can actually make them. And yeah, it should be kind of fun. There's always something that I want to talk about. So I don't think I'll run out of things to talk about in the world of cameras and filming and editing and all that jazz and running your own video business, just in marketing in general. I like doing that too. And that's really, really a part of my success and my business, is being able to extend that over to my clients so I can adapt to what they're trying to get out there and present and help them do that in hopefully the best way possible. My clients are happy, so it seems to be working pretty well. All right, I'll talk to you guys on the next one. Peace. Oh, I gotta turn it off over here. I'm so used to turning it off on the camera. I'm gonna turn it off right here. Right here. Did it stop? Oh, I've got a message up. See, I'm just learning how to do this.